Hello everyone and welcome to my channel Revise with Blue. Today's video is about back to school advice. This video is a collab with some of my friends, Torquoise Star, the Successive Studies and Studies Age. So be sure to check them out. I will link the channels in the description box below. Now let's move on to the video. Tip number 1. Use a planner or bullet journal. Planners or bullet journals are really helpful. You can use them to pre-plan your days. Then when you pre-plan your days, your life will become more easier and try to follow through those plans. Don't let your work pile up, and in this way you will be able to know the deadlines of your assignments. Make to-do lists. In this way you will be able to save your time and will procrastinate less, and you will be able to know when you should complete a certain task, and make a plan and then stick to it. Believe me, if you will use a planner, your life will be saved. So I just wanted to add a bonus tip. So just remember that grades matter, but they don't define you at all. So like, if you get a little bit of less marks than you expected in your class, then don't think about death, or like, don't think that you are the biggest loser in this world. There are a lot of people that are below you. So remember that you are not alone in this world, and you will reach the destination that is set for you. No one can take away what is supposed to be for you. A lot of students say that they studied a lot, they worked so hard, but the result was a disappointment, just like I think. It happens when sometimes things do not work out the way you want. Like the checkers, they check the paper in a different way that you are not used to, or your teachers do not check in that way. So do not worry at all. Your grades do not define who you are as a person. They only matter a little bit in your life. Like, no one can take away your knowledge. You should have knowledge. And I have seen so many people who have really big degrees, but they do not know anything at all. So you should study to get knowledge, to increase your knowledge, and to teach yourself the ways of living life in this world, which is never taught in the schools. And you should not die only for the grades. You should actually learn something else from the books you are reading. They should not be a wastage of your time. Tip number 2 is to fix your schedule. Sleep and wake up early every day. I sleep for 6 hours every night, and it's enough for students, according to me. During exams I sleep for 4 to 5 hours, but you can do whatever you like. I mean, make your own schedule. Don't be lazy, you can make your life hard due to this. Make a schedule and follow it daily, and change it whenever you feel the need of changing it. And the things that work for others may not work for you, so remember this too. Just a quick disclaimer, I know that I sound like a weirdo, English isn't my first language, and I am doing a voiceover after 8 to 9 months, and I'm not used to of doing voiceovers, and my area where I live, it's really noisy. I'm doing a voiceover at midnight, and when school will start, I don't think so that I will be able to stay up this much late. So if I don't upload a lot of videos with voiceovers, please do not hate me for that. I cannot do voiceover for every video, and to be honest, I don't like to do voiceovers. Like, it's so cringy when I listen to my own voice in a video. Tip number 3, set time limits. Tell yourself that you will do a certain task for this much amount of time, and then try your best to complete that task in that time limit. Setting time limits help you to procrastinate less, and you will know that you don't have enough time to waste. Find the time at which you are more productive. Some people prefer mornings. I am more of a night owl. I am recording this voiceover at midnight. So try to find which time works best for you, and at which time you are more productive. And remember that only give time to things that really matter. Don't waste your time, or else you will regret it, just like I do sometimes. Tip number 4, stay organized and keep your study space clean. When you will have a clean study space, you will like to work for longer periods of time. You will get a lot of stuff done in short periods of time without wasting your time. Changing and cleaning your study space helps a lot. Change your environment, change the setting of your desk. It will help you a lot. You will feel motivated to do a lot of work. Work at places you like library, cafes, or your desk. I prefer my desk. I don't know where the library of my area is, to be honest. So my desk is the best. Find what works best for you. So my last tip is to set goals. Setting goals lets you know what you have to do and on which thing you should spend more of your time. Ask yourself where you want to end up at the end of the school year. You will feel motivated Remember that motivation shouldn't be relied on. When you will set goals, you will know what you have to focus on most of the time, and you will be able to ignore the stuff that is not important and that will not help you at all. So be sure to set goals for yourself, and good luck.